Change of plans for today's programme. Today we're on two wheels. Well, maybe. I think that sooner or later, everyone gets the desire to explore, wants to know about new places, new seas, and there's particular appeal to those places you can only reach by boat. To satisfy this special desire, all you need is a canoe, but we do have our physical limits. So a boat would be much better. What type of boat, though? Big? No, not so necessary. But for sure, it needs to be practical and functional. And eureka! This is exactly what Crankey has been working on in their new construction, the T36, which has just been launched. Crossover, in the automotive sector, is a term used for cars which have many different types of use, just like this boat. The T36 is a yacht because it is luxurious. It can have two or three cabins and looks like a trawler, which means it is one of those models made to sail forever, making valuable use of every bit of space and its low fuel consumption. But it is also quick and can host a tender. Bicycles too. Think of it as a houseboat. To sum up, this boat can do a lot of things. It's a little explorer. You could say a compact and bijou exploration boat, coming in at just 10 meters long. Before setting sail, let's have a quick look below deck and inside. This area is like a water garden, water right in the midst of the sea, but we can barbecue. I can't even remember such an airy living room on a boat of this size. I mentioned before that it can come in a three-cabin version, but this is a boat that can sleep up to eight if the sofa is a sofa bed, which means it's like being on a 20-meter boat. We've seen the kitchen unit outside, but there is also another one in here too, inside. The deck house looks like a veranda because it is glassed in and sheltered, even at the stern. It's like a houseboat. It could be used all year round. This air conditioning room can be enjoyed in mid-August or at Christmas. The roof has a nice slender profile, both at the bow and at the stern. You can close the cockpit with awnings and wind protectors. The sofa, as you can see, has been made as big as possible. At the bow, there's the usual sun deck, but you can also lie down in the shade here. You can even get on the roof to sunbathe, but be careful, there are just the handles to hold onto and they're quite hard to catch hold of because they're low. The master cabin is at the bow with a wardrobe on one side and a drawer unit on the other. The guest cabin has two single beds that join together to form a very large double. There is a wardrobe and a chest of drawers. The third cabin has overlapping bunks. The version with two cabins, however, seems best because there is a second bathroom for guests, while in this version, with three cabins, there's just one bathroom, but it does have headspace. It's comfortable and has a separate shower area. The fabrics, upholstery and finishes are of a high standard too. Boatyard, one of the best in the world for its production process organization, is also able to customize fitting and fixtures on the yacht with a varied range of choice. The Crankey T36 crossover is 11 meters 85 centimeters long, which technically, at least in Italy, means it's classified as a boat with a hull length of precisely 999 centimeters.
È piuttosto largo.
It is quite wide though, coming in at 352 centimeters, which makes it a great living space.
Lo hanno equipaggiato con due motori da 300 cavalli, i D4 della Volvo.
They've equipped it with two Volvo Penta D300 horsepower engines, perhaps a bit excessive for a small trawler.
Questo tipo di barca non è fatto per stabilire un primato di velocità, piuttosto per portarci.
This type of boat isn't designed for setting speed records. It's really for long journeys that consume little. That's why you can choose less powerful engines.
Ecco, un trawler dovrebbe essere utilizzato a questa velocità.
A trawler should really be used at this speed, 9 knots and 1400 RPM. Fuel consumption is even slightly less than a litre per mile for each engine, so that's 2 litres per mile in total. With a full fuel tank, that would be 600 litres, so we could travel 300 miles then.
In pratica, per fare un esempio, da questa zona.
Which in practical terms means, for example, from this area, the Marano Lagoon, up to the Tremeti Islands in Puglia, along the entire Adriatic coast.
Questo tipo di barca.
This type of boat is made to really enjoy the journey too, taking it slowly and with this speed, making it last as long as possible.
Adesso però per fare il nostro solito
But
test,
now to do our no fear, no limits test. Oh, I need to stop for a minute and take the bicycles off though.
L'imbarcazione pesa 8 tonnellate e mezzo, ma a pieno carico potrebbe raggiungere le 10 tonnellate e mezzo.
The boat weighs 8.5 tons, but fully loaded could reach 10.5 tons. This might be the reason that the makers decided to add a bit of horsepower, but efficiency of the stern drive on this boat gets good results, even with less power.
Ai piedi poppieri, inoltre, dobbiamo riconoscere l'incredibile agilità e la reattività.
I want to highlight the incredible agility and responsiveness of this stern drive too, even going slowly. This is all good news for those without much boat experience who want to be able to maneuver easily in tight spaces.
Ora cominciamo a navigare e ci facciamo aiutare dai sistemi.
So now we're really beginning to get going. With a little help from the electronic systems on board, like the Volvo Penta Trim Assist, which adjusts the trim or the inclination of the stern drive. Then there's the automatic flaps of Humphrey, which have rather large blades but are very efficient.
Sentite? Le turbine stanno spingendo lo.
Can you hear that? The turbines are pushing the boat to plane. The angle of incidence is quite high at this stage. We're around 7 degrees, but just a little more fuel and see how we glide across the water.
Se decidete di navigare a 16 nodi con i motori a 2250.
If you decide to sail at 16 knots with engines of 2250 revs per minute, you should know that the total fuel consumption for both engines would be 3.8 liters per mile. I'm telling you this now because I'm going to show you what happens with a little more gas.
Siamo portati a 20 nodi, motori a 2400 giri minuto.
We've reached 20 knots and 2400 revs per minute, and it seems even quieter. It seems like they're making less effort, and in fact they're also consuming less fuel. 1.6 liters per mile for each engine, 3.2 liters per mile in total, versus the 3.8 from earlier.
Lo hanno chiamato crossover perché non va solo piano.
It's called crossover because it doesn't just go slowly, it goes fast too. We are going 25 knots and consumption is even lower, 1.4 liters per mile each engine, that is 2.8 liters total, which means the faster we go, the less we consume. So you see, the hull hasn't just been made to go slowly. With the 300 horsepower Volvo Penta D4 engines, we can keep a steady speed at 3000 revs per minute, i.e. a speed of 28 knots. What is fuel consumption though? Just the same as before, 2.8 liters per mile.
Ora, una barca così corta.
Now such a short boat, with such an impressive superstructure, well, naturally, you feel the wind and the waves a bit, but the automatic flap control system helps a lot. And even using the throttle, it keeps working,
Ad esempio adesso i flap sono completamente spariti e questo è il motivo per cui...
For example, now the flaps are completely down, which is why we have a slight pitching on these waves, but we're still going 36 knots.
Ecco, qui finisce il nostro test e sarebbe...
Our test ends. Time to start exploring now.